Well, since I'm here, like, shopping spree?
Shopping spree.
You're probably wondering how I got here. Let's recap. The Bakersfield, this place is really, really tiny. So, just waiting for Cameron to pick me up. And yeah, those kids are screaming because they see somebody. Who knows? Maybe they just saw Cube Solve Hero. Who knows? I'm gonna go with Cube Solve Hero. Anderson Ticket talking Mazda for the biggest. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it. Anderson Ticket talking Mazda for the biggest. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta so just got to Speed Cube Shop here with Cameron Brown. We're gonna do a quick tour of the space. I was here last year and haven't had a chance to see all the updates and add-ons to the space, so I figured we'd do a quick little tour.
A lot has changed, so let's go ahead and dive right into it.
Yeah, so what is this overall space for?
So this is our current showroom configuration. We're always changing the showroom to try to have some of the newest releases. Like we have the MGC 5x5, 6x6, a little bit of kind of everything out here. So we have twisty puzzles, lubes, just kind of everything that you would really want to try if you're coming to visit our showroom. We have people that come in from, we've had people that come in from some pretty amazing distances to come and visit. So it's definitely really fun to meet all of you and be able to let you try out some cool Speed Cubes on the site.
So anybody can come over here whenever they want. They don't need to like make an appointment. They just come on through and like a retail shop.
Yep.
Oh, that's cool.
Yes, we're open 9 to 5, Monday through Friday, and 9 to 1 on Saturdays.
Jackpot. Coming here, do you do tours at all if someone wanted to come by?
Absolutely.
So, can you tour me around a little bit?
Yeah, let's do it. So let's start off by showing you our custom cube and spare parts room.
All right, so what goes on in here?
So this is where we build all of our Supernova, Cosmic cubes, soon to be Uni cubes, UCuber cubes, so your cubes are also built here. And we also do our pro setup services. So this is where we have everything we need to make what we believe is the best Speed Cubes in the world.
Awesome. And what's that?
This is our current spare parts in process area. So right now on the website, we are completely redoing our spare parts ordering system to make it the most interactive, easy to use system that we think exists today. So right now we're going through and just cataloging all of our current parts, bagging them all up, making sure it's all perfect as it needs to be, then reprinting them on the website. So you'll see those live really soon.
Dang. And right here, what, all these stickers?
So these are just some extra logos that we just had done. So when these are all finished, these are the ones we use exactly for the logos. They're double layered vinyl, so they don't fade or anything, and they probably outlast life of the cube, frankly.
Jeez. Do you do the stickers in here as well?
Yep.
Like, do you cut the stickers in here?
Yeah, so you do everything in here. Wanna take a look?
Yeah.
Cool, let's do that. So this room is a little bit funny. It actually used to be my office until the sticker operation outgrew the old sticker room, so they had to move into here. So this is an example of one of our sticker stations. We have over 70 different colors of vinyl. It's all the highest grade that we have available. Rated for over 10 years of outdoor UV exposure, chip resistant, peel resistant, really good stuff.
Dang. So how many colors do you have just here in stock?
Right now we have over 80, and we're gonna be logging some of the new ones up onto the website.
Wow, dang. So cutting everything done in here?
Yep, so we have a bunch of different templates. We have an example of one vinyl cutter right here. And yeah, it's a whole operation, and we do our best to make sure that we design our own templates in-house so they're really perfect and accurate. We do the fitted and the full fitted sizes, and also, you know, we just try to make sure that everything's the best. We take pride in all of our work.
Very cool. All right, so what's over there?
Cool, let's take a look. So this is gonna be our customer care and support room.
Nice.
So all of our phone calls, live chats, emails, returns, anything when you contact us is all handled in here by one of our friendly team members. So we take a lot of pride in our customer support, and we do whatever we can to try to make everybody happy and provide the best just possible service.
Very cool. So One thing everyone probably wants to see at this point is, where do you keep the cubes?
Well, a better question is, where don't we keep the cubes? So let's go ahead and find location one.
All right.
So this is one of our overstock locations. This is where we house all of the sealed cartons of inventory that has to make its way to our picking locations. So we've been in the space for just over a year now, and we've already like overrun the office with inventory. So we're looking at actually leasing out a whole other building right next door just to house all this stuff.
And that was like super far back over there. So, I mean, like, is that all the inventory you have here, overstock?
That's only one of the locations. So we have even more to see. Let's go ahead and check that out.
Jeez.
Okay, so this is gonna be our second inventory location. This is where we actually start picking products for the orders and use them to fulfill.
Dang, this is a ton of stuff. So what's this?
So that's gonna be our lounge.
Can I go up there?
Sorry, VIP customers only.
So what's next?
All right, let's check it out.
All right.
Take a look at our new order packing area. So since we've rolled this out, we've been packing orders even faster than before, and we've had a 99.9% order packing accuracy.
So could I pack an order?
Well, remember last time? Still want to pack an order?
Probably not a good idea.
Yeah, let's keep going.
Okay.
This is the last bit of our loose inventory that we also use to pick orders. So this is, we're always trying to keep it refilled and manage all of this. So it's pretty big task keeping it all stocked all the time.
Whew. I mean, geez. Well, since I'm here, like, shopping spree?
Shopping spree.
Alright, it's time to unbox the most products I've ever unboxed in my life. Since my camera isn't set up to slide a big box on the table, let me show you a quick look at everything before I tear into it. This is gonna be insane. Quick note, I've unboxed a lot of this stuff already from Speedcube Shop, and I'll be linking every video that I've unboxed in the upper right-hand corner. As always, be sure to support my channel by clicking that subscribe button and the bell to be notified of upcoming videos. Also, be sure to give this video a like and share it, and don't forget to use discount code HERO at checkout on all your orders on speedcubeshop.com. Okay, I think we're ready. Let's do this. Alright, first up, let's crack into that 10x10 and 11x11 Huanglong from speedcubeshop.com. These are massive, and probably the biggest 10x10 and 11x11 on the market, size-wise. So, I'm naturally tempted to break these down, but there are so many products to go through that I'll probably save these for another video. Type in the comments if I should make a video smashing these apart and rebuilding them. Don't worry, I can wait for you to make that comment. Okay. The 10x10 is $113 and the 11x11 is $122.50, both using discount code HERO at checkout on speedcubeshop.com. So if you're itching to get one of these really big cubes, click the link in the description and make that happen. Okay, on to the next, we have a shoulder bag and some lubes. The Mini Cube bag is cool, but not really my style. Honestly, I got this for Mini Cube Solve Hero because I think it's super cute, and I think she'll really enjoy wearing it. The backpack itself has some decent storage, and for $14.20 using code HERO on SpeedCube Shop, it really isn't a bad buy. As for the lubes, I had to stock up on my favorite go-tos, Controlius, Martian, and Solar. These are what I use for various combinations on virtually all my setups. Controlius will slow your cube down a bit, but it's not gummy at all. For me, it's a total game changer, and by now, if you haven't seen my videos on this plus the Martian and Solar lubes, give it a watch. Controlius is $5.65, and the 10cc Martian and 10cc Solar are both $8.50 using code HERO. Up next, I have some fun keychain cubes. I have the Pyraminx, the 2x2, and the Barrel 3x3. These are just cool to have around, and personally, I keep a 3x3 in my keys because it's just a fun conversation starter. They turn decently, so that's a plus, and for only $2.80 using code HERO on SpeedCube Shop, these aren't really that bad of a buy. So if you want something cool to have in your keys, I recommend grabbing some. Okay, so this next series is something I've wanted to feature all at once for a long time now. So now I have the entire Mei-Long series from the 2x2 all the way to the 12x12. Granted, there is no 8x8 Mei-Long, that's still the MF series. Got the 2x2 and the 3x3 are both $3.75. The 4x4 is $6.60. The 5x5 is $7.55. The 6x6 is $8.50. The 7x7 is $9.45. The 9x9 is $33.20. The 10x10 is $56.95. The 11x11 is $94.95. And the 12x12 is $113.95. Whew. Of course, these are all adjusted using code HERO at checkout. If you've been watching my videos, you know that I love the Mei-Long series. For a budget cube, these are absolute game-changing. And honestly, for my Mei-Long 3x3, I've magnetized it with 96 magnets, and I love this cube. Additionally, I have the M versions of the 3x3, the 4x4, and the 5x5, which I've never tried. These aren't that strong magnetically, and I prefer to magnetize them myself, but you know, for having these come stock magnetized, that's honestly pretty cool. So overall, the 2x2 through the 12x12 series probably needs its own standalone video to detail everything. So if you agree, in the comments, let me know if I should make that happen. Now for another massive cube you've probably seen before, I have another 17x17 to show you. Not only have I unboxed this before, but I've also smashed it apart and rebuilt it. So I'll link those videos up top. This thing weighs like 6 pounds, and I've yet to actually scramble and solve it. So I know it's a shame, and I'll eventually make that happen, but this bad boy has dropped in price a bit and is now $474.95 using code HERO at checkout on speedcubeshop.com. So let's go ahead and condense this down to the Huanglong 3x3. I had the C4 and I really enjoyed it. However, my cousin wanted to learn the 3x3, and at the time, I gave this one to her. Either way, I have it back now. It's a little spendy, and to be honest, there are a lot more cubes you can get for cheaper. This one in particular is $25.60 using code HERO. So onto something smaller, I have the Pink Edition Vault 3 Mini. This one comes without stickers applied, so let's throw some stickers on it. Much better. I love how the pink shades pop out with the stickers. This one is just a cool little cube, and it looks great with my regular black Vault 3 Mini in my collection. This is $17.05 using code HERO, and it's just really cool to have in your collection. Up next, let's crack into some animal cubes. I have the YJ Fortune Cat, the YJ Elephants in both blue and pink, as well as the Yushin Panda. These are all 2x2 shape mods and are just really fun, not only to play with, but to display. This panda in particular is going to my best friend's daughter, Ember. She's super cute and will have a great time playing with this panda cube. The Fortune Cat and Elephants are all $7.55, while the Yushin Panda is $12.30 using code HERO. Speaking of YJ, I have the new pocket timer. Looks like it's supposed to sense vibration from the table or something, but actually, as I can see here on the sides, there are some sensors, so I'm assuming that's to detect movement. It's only $9.45 using code HERO, and it's probably not something I'll ever use. Next, I have a whole new setup for my wife's classroom. I have the 2x2, 3x3, and 4x4 of the Chi MS cubes. These are amazing, and for the money, I feel will be a massive upgrade from the Guanlongs I gave her last year. The 2x2 is $6.60, the 3x3 is $7.55, and the 4x4 is $11.35 using code HERO, and they are worth every single penny. Since we're talking about Chi, I have to bring up the fidget spinner series. In this collection, there is black plastic, clear, blue, pink, and clear dark blue. These are the longest lasting spinners I've ever had and are built extremely well. They also turn and manipulate well too. These are $12.30 using code HERO. Up next, let's bring out three different things. I have a Dian, I'm going to butcher these names, but I have the Dian Shuang Feiyan Cube, the Yushin Multi-Scube, and the Lego 3x3 from the Feiyan, is $23.70. The Multi-Scube is $33.20. And that Lego Cube is now $6.60 using code HERO. The Lego Cube is one I've had, and I'll link that video up top. It's really cool, and it actually does work with existing Legos, even though it's technically not Lego branded. As for the Dian Shuang Feiyan Cube and the Yushin Multi-Scube Cube, these are just cool. I've never played with them, and I've wanted to play with that Multi-Scube for a long time now. I consider breaking this down for a future video, and if it's something you'd like to see in the future, just go ahead and let me know in the comments. Okay, let's bring out another huge cube you've seen before. I have the MoYu 15x15, and this is probably my favorite cube in my collection. I don't normally like stickered cubes, but this one is just beautiful. It turns great, and it's much smaller and more handheld than my 17x17. I have made an unboxing, and I've also broken this down, and it's also for $284.95 using code HERO on SpeedCube Shop. I'll link both videos up top, and I really recommend watching it, because those breakdowns and rebuilds took me forever. Now, it's time for some clocks. I don't have the new Qi clock yet, but I'll make sure to do a comparison once I get it. For now, I have the Lingao Magic Clock and the newer Shengshao Magnetic Clock. Both of these prices are at $9.45 using code HERO. And honestly, I can't imagine why anyone would go for a non-magnetic clock if it's the same price. With that said, I've never done clock before and I've wanted to learn. Maybe I'll make a video of me learning the clock and or maybe showing how to solve it once I've done it. We'll see. In the comments, would you want to see me do a tutorial on the clock once I've learned it? If so, again, like I said, comment. Now it's time to yeet this up. Ever since I saw Tingman's video, I've wanted to have this. Not only is it a cool ball, but it's also called a yeet, which is pretty epic. Looks like this came kind of scrambled up a bit out of the box. So I guess I'll smash this one and look inside. So nothing super crazy to look at here. I think it's like an Ivy Cube mod. So that's pretty cool. Let's go ahead and snap this back to place. Nice. The Yeet Ball is $5.65 using code HERO on SpeedCube Shop. And for that price, why not get one? It's just cool, it's interesting, and it's affordable. Next four are all new to me, and they are the Qiyi Gear Pyraminx, the Qiyi 3x3 Gear Cube, the Qiyi 3x3 Gear Ball, and the Qiyi 3x3 Barrel. All for $6.60 using code HERO. I can confidently say that I've never solved a Gear Cube, and frankly, they overwhelm me. Too much can go wrong quickly, and I've yet to take the risk. If you'd like to see more in-depth breakdown, I'm happy to make another video. Just let me know in the comments. These turn really well, and they appear to be really well made. So I tip my hat to Qiyi for releasing a lot of cool stuff this year. Up next is the Shadow M 6x6 from X-Men. I've surprisingly never had this in my collection, and I've wanted to see what the hype is all about. So going into some first turns, it turns really well, and I suppose I shouldn't be shocked because it's $47.45 using code HERO. It's solid, it might be a main contender once I break it in, but I really do enjoy my MGC 6x6 a lot because it's a solid cube and it's about half the price. So I'll play with this again and I'll update you if it is my main going into my 2021 mains and goals video. The last four you've all seen before and I'll link the videos. I have the Dian Tangyuan M 3x3 for $24.65. I have the Goiguan 3x3 for $18.95. I have the MGC 5x5 for $20.85 and the MGC 6x6 for $23.70. I love all these and I currently main the MGC 5x5 and 6x6 because they're just heavily undervalued. I remember when I first got the Goiguan with these game-changing magnets that you could adjust, and I'm really pleased to see Dian step it up with the Tangyuan V2. All of these are solid cubes, and I feel are all worth the price. So, there you have it. Okay, we did it. That was insane. And all of this retails for a total of $2,005.85. I know that this isn't realistic for a video. And for me, it was just fun doing something to piggyback off my original $1,000 unboxing. So I had to step it up with that $2,000 unboxing. So please put in the comments anything you'd like me to make a dedicated video on. And I'll pick a few suggestions from the comments. So I hope you all enjoyed it. And I hope you all consider supporting my channel by subscribing and using discount code HERO at checkout on all your orders on SpeedCube. thecubeshop.com. If you're new to the channel, be sure to click that subscribe button as well as the bell to be notified of upcoming videos. Be sure you're also using discount code HERO at checkout for any and all speedcubeshop.com orders. Don't forget to give this video a like as well as comment any thoughts or questions below. Additionally, I started a merch site, so don't hesitate to check out the link in the description and consider supporting my channel. Lastly, follow me on Instagram as well as join my Discord. Links in the description. And until next time, happy cubing.